Could I please ask Year 12 to please make their way outside? And if parents and friends could just start to make your way to your seats, and we hope to get started very shortly. Thank you. arrogant. If I could please ask everyone to take their seats, we'll get started very, very shortly. Good afternoon, everyone. To commence our ceremony this afternoon, I'd like to invite to the lectern Eliza Cook and Annabelle Mansour to acknowledge country and to lead us in prayer.
We acknowledge and pay respect to the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, the Bidjigal people of the Eora Nation. It is upon their ancestral land that Bridgetine College is built. As we share our own knowledge, teaching, and learning practices within this school, may we also pay respect to the knowledge embedded forever within the Aboriginal custodianship of country. We acknowledge the Bridgetine Sisters. The sisters founded our school and have taught here across the generations. They showed us how to be people of strength and gentleness, and we are proud to continue in their charism.
We gather today to celebrate and give thanks for our Year 12 students who this week graduate from Bridgetine College and their years of formal high school. We pray that God will fill them with the fire of the Holy Spirit to go forward into post-school life with the passion and commitment to make a difference in this world. Let's begin our prayer by turning our hearts and minds to God and reminding ourselves that we are always in the presence of God, who calls us to make a difference. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. God of wisdom and light, we seek your blessing on these young women as they step into their future lives. You call them to be the salt and light for the world, to bring the flavour of your presence into the world, and to reflect your love, bringing light to all we meet. Make our graduates salt for this world, so that their lives may be an echo of your presence. May them light for this world, so that their lives may be a reflection of your love. Bless them with hope, that they may enter fully into their lives. Bless them with courage, that they may act with confidence. Bless them with questions, that they may challenge blindness. Bless them with mercy, that they may live with compassion. Bless them with peace, that they may know your joy. Bless them with vision, that they may live with purpose. Bless them with strength, that they may challenge injustice. Bless them with love, that they may be your love in the world. bless them with faith, that they may recognise your loving presence. Gracious God, hear the prayers we make for these graduating students. Hold them, enfold them, embrace them, and protect them. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the light of the world. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
My eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call me crazy. We can live in a world that we design. 'Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping from far away. Special things I compile, each one there to make you smile on a rainy day. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we've lost our minds. I don't care if they call us crazy. Run away to a world that we desire.
Good afternoon, parents, staff and students. My name is Julie Norman and I am the Assistant Principal of our college. It is with great pleasure that I extend a very warm welcome to you all here this afternoon as we publicly acknowledge and celebrate the achievements of our current Year 12 cohort, the graduating class of 2023. We extend a very warm welcome to the families and friends of our Year 12 2023. And I would also like to extend a warm welcome to our college executive and to our staff. I would now like to invite to the lectern our college principal, Mrs. Sharon Quirk, to give her address to the graduating class of 2023.
Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty, proud parents, and most importantly, the remarkable class of 2023. Today, as I stand before you, my heart swells with profound sense of pride and joy. It is with immense pleasure and deep gratitude that I address you on this momentous occasion, your graduation day. This is a day that makes the culmination of years of hard work, determination and growth, not only for you, our incredible students, but also for the entire college community. Class of 2023, you are not just any graduating class. You are a symbol of resilience and adaptability. Your journey through high school was unlike any other in recent memory. You faced unprecedented challenges, from the uncertainty of a global pandemic to the countless personal hurdles that life threw your way. Yet, you persevered, you adapted, and you emerged stronger than ever. I want to acknowledge at this moment the unwavering support of your parents, guardians, grandparents, and families who stood by you, encouraging you, nurturing your dreams. I'd like now to take a moment for the class of 23 to actually applaud our beautiful families who have supported us in this journey. Thank you, families. Our dedicated faculty and staff have also been instrumental in your success. They have guided, mentored, and inspired you to reach this point. Together, we have created a nurturing environment where you can flourish, learn, and grow. Now, as you stand on the precipice of a new chapter in your lives, I want you to remember that the world you are about to enter is filled with endless possibilities and opportunities. You are equipped with not only knowledge, but also the strength of character that comes from overcoming adversity. As you step out into the world, I encourage you to be fearless in your pursuits, to dream big, and to never underestimate the power of your own potential. Life will undoubtedly present you with challenges, but I have faith that you will approach them with the same determination that has brought you to this moment. Class of 2023, you have already demonstrated your ability to adapt and thrive. You have shown resilience, compassion, and a deep sense of community. These qualities will serve you as your compass and will allow you to navigate the uncharted waters of the future. Remember, you are not alone on this journey. You have the support of your family, your friends, and the lessons you have learned within the walls of this college. Hold on to the friendships that you have forged here, for they are the threads that will weave the tapestry of your life. In closing, I would like to leave you with a quote from the wonderful Nelson Mandela, who once said, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Class of 2023, you are now armed with that weapon. I have no doubt that you will use it wisely and make a profound impact on this world. After all, you are Brigidine girls who walk with fortiter et suaviter. Always be proud of who you are, embrace opportunities, and remember, you've left a legacy we will cherish. Congratulations, graduates. The world awaits your brilliance, your kindness, and your boundless potential. Go forth and make us proud. Seize life with both hands and enjoy the ride. It's yours to take. Thank you, and may your journey ahead be filled with endless success and happiness. Congratulations, class of 2023. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Quirk. We will now commence the ceremony by announcing the graduates of 2023. It is with pleasure and pride that we acknowledge the achievement of completing 13 years of schooling. Student academic excellence, endeavour, and their contributions to extracurricular activities play a pivotal role in fostering both personal growth and academic success. These endeavours go beyond the classroom, allowing students to develop leadership skills, excel in their coursework, and build a strong sense of community. Recognising these achievements with academic cords symbolises the multifaceted talents and dedication of our students. Light blue represents leadership, highlighting the importance of guiding and inspiring others. Gold signifies first in course, celebrating academic excellence. Silver represents Canatus, showcasing the drive and ambition of our students. Red stands for the Big Sister Tutoring, exemplifying the spirit of mentorship and support. Maroon embodies debating, emphasising critical thinking and effective communication. And lastly, purple signifies music, underscoring the harmony that extracurricular activities bring to our educational journey. Together, these chords exemplify the holistic education we provide, where both inside and outside the classroom, experiences contribute to well-rounded, successful individuals. This afternoon, these young women will graduate in their pastoral care classes. Students will be announced by their pastoral care teacher, a teacher who has journeyed with these girls throughout their pivotal years. The college principal presents the graduation certificates for a simple, practical reason. It is a way to acknowledge and formalise the students' successful completion of their academic journey, their official graduation. This tradition adds a touch of formality and authority to the ceremony, as the principal is the highest ranking academic official in the institution. While it may not be about sentimentality, it does reinforce the significance of the accomplishment and the authority behind it. It's a way to symbolise the end of one chapter and the beginning of another for our graduates. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Ms. Nadia Evdokimova, the pastoral care teacher for Aquinas, and our principal, Mrs. Sharon Quirk. And could I please ask that you hold your applause until each house graduates?
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduates of Aquinas House. Erin Anthony. Caitlin Baldock. Laura Cassis. Celine Chia. Eliza Cook, SRC Captain. Ellie Cooper. Claire Culligan. Jesse Curtis. Jolie Davies. Caitlin D'Andrade. Ruby DeSoma. Monica Figueroa. Precious Lazo. Vanessa Lee. Catherine Loke, Aquinas House Captain. Ginger Alexin. Arabella Ramos. Jediah Simpelalong. Tegan Rose Sarmento. Ava Smith. Serena Sue. Caitlin Strawbridge. Lily Townsend. Let us congratulate Year 12 Aquinas. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Charlie Blackshaw, the pastoral care teacher for Bridget.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduates of Bridget House. Lucy Andrews. Bridget House Captain. Charlize Ashby. Chloe Ashton. Phoebe Bernardo. Rose Cuddle. Tess Di Bartolo. Matilda Dibb, Social Justice Captain. Kira Evans. Scarlett Foster. Gemma Guthrie. Grace Heyman. Caitlin Hill. Maya James. Emily Levisianis, College Vice Captain. Chloe Mintoff. Sophie Murphy. Sophia Otten. Ursula Palmer. Anastasia Petropoulos. Tess Quilligan. Ellie Sherman. Stacia Tan. Ashley Walker, Bridget House Captain. Jasmine Wooden. Emma Yap. Let us congratulate 12 Bridget. please join me in welcoming to the stage Karen Bataille, the pastoral care teacher for Delaney.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduates of Delaney House. Alexia Alisevsky. Layla Askey. Olivia Berry. Delaney House Captain. Charlotte Blackett. Jessica Charlesworth. Jessica Gibbons. Sarah Graff. Roisin Hanger. Meg Hamilton. Georgia Hickey. Aaliyah Hurtado. Olivia Koo. Jackie Costanjanis. Vanessa Cunha-Witty. Jade Lloyd-Jones. Jordan McCaskill. Sophia Mamo. Fiona Neurotsis. Phoebe Petru. Marianne Pham Nguyen. Caitlin Pitt. Tiana Radomir. Imogen Sampieri. Jessica Schroeder. Zara Williamson, Delaney House Captain. Let us congratulate Year 12 Delaney. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Claire Rose, the pastoral teacher for Regina Mundi.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduands of Regina Mundi. Lulu Brown. Eleni Karayas. Desiree DeVolio. Alicia Dickens. Elizabeth Frawley, Sustainability Captain. Jessica Haler. Yasmin Janchik. College Captain. Jasmine Kamaluddin. Hannah Collin Sherry. Demi Krikitos.
Tried.
Sarah Lucas. Charlie Limbury Ashton. Ivana Manavis. Ruby Monks. Bridie Morrison. Hallie Pizzonato. Charlie Reynolds, Regina Mundi House Captain. Ruby Robb. Samantha Stevens. Elka Samarawa. Mary Vasiliadis. Jessica Winter. Isabella Woods, Regina Mundi House Captain. Ashley Wu. Let us congratulate Year 12 Regina Mundi. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Maya Mabey, the pastoral care teacher for Winifred.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduates of Winifred House. Serena Assey. Sarah Bureau. Nicola Casimaris. Melinda Charlesworth. Paul Collins. Yeah, Paul! Brina Conan. Yeah, Winifred House Captain. Claire Davidson. Chloe Deng. Holly Gray. Ella Howard. Faith Marion Ibarra, Arts and Culture Captain. Caitlin Indrawan. Emma Carpus. Sophia Keith. Samara Alicia. Annabelle Mansour, Faith and Charism Captain. Yasmin Mari. Paige Mascott, Winifred House Captain. Jenna Osberg. Jasmine Panessi. Lily Robinson. Mia Shaloub. Ava Sheeran. Annalisa Trapke. Let us congratulate Year 12, Winifred. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Gus Lyon, the pastoral care teacher for Xavier.
Ms. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduates of Xavier House. Amani Odisho. Sophia Bell, Xavier House Captain. Olivia Casey. Mia Lily Cronin. Yay, go, Olivia D'Arujo. Nadia Dizon. Keza Ishimwe. Ava Kalajarakis, Xavier House Captain. Taryn Lafferty. Elsa Lane. Elsa. Mia Lay. Isabella Mattis. Elise Mendez. Mariah Ruby Nestoris. Amelia O'Leary. Shauna Peppard. Sarah Pignatelli, sports captain. Natalie Rico Guevara. Emma Rogers. Emily Shepherd. Isabella Thompson. Riley Williams. Catherine Wong. Let us congratulate 12 Xavier.
Congratulations once again, girls. We will now commence with the presentation of awards. I would now like to invite to the stage Ms. Eleonora Agazzi, our Director of Curriculum, to conduct the presentation of the Canatus Awards.
It is my absolute pleasure to commence the award ceremony by acknowledging the dedication and effort of a number of our Year 12 students. Across Year 11 and Year 12, students have been awarded an effort grade. The effort grade is determined by a student's application and approach to learning throughout a semester. In 2023, we acknowledge student effort through the Canatus Award. Canatus is the Latin for effort. And with this award, we recognise students who consistently apply themselves and approach learning with tenacity and a desire to strive for their personal best. The Canatus Award is awarded to students who have maintained a grade point average of 5 across all semesters in Year 11 and Year 12. To achieve a 5-point GPA, students have achieved an A grade for effort across all subjects studied at the college. In 2023, the Canatus Award is presented to the following students. Chloe Ashton. Woo! Rose Cattle. Claire Culligan. Caitlin D'Andrade. Olivia D'Arujo. Chloe Deng. Matilda Dibb. Jessica Gibbons. Ella Howard. Faith Marion Ibarra. Caitlin Indrawan. Maya James. Yasmin Janchek. Jasmine Kamaludin. Emma Copps. Olivia Koo. Hannah Colin Cherry. Jacqueline Costagianis. Elsa Lane. Precious Lazo. Emily Levisianis. Catherine Loke. Charlie Limbury Ashton. Ivana Manavis. Isabella Matis. Sarah Pignatelli. Emma Rogers. Ellie Sheeman. Mary Vasiliadis. Ashley Wu. Please join me in congratulating all of our award recipients. I would now like to invite Ms. Natasha Fox, our Director of Learning and Innovation, to conduct the presentation of the Academic Awards. It is my absolute pleasure to conduct the presentation of the Academic Awards. Could I ask that you please hold your applause until each department's awards have been received? I would like to invite the Director of Religious Education and Mission, Ms. Jamie Lee Wood, to join Mrs. Quirk for the presentations of the awards in religious education. The medal for first place in Studies of Religion 2 is presented to Yasmin Janchek. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 2 is presented to Charlie Limberry Ashton. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 2 is also presented to Amelia O'Leary. The medal for first place in Studies of Religion 1 is presented to Elsa Lane. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 1 is presented to Emma Carps. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 1 is also presented to Olivia Koo. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 1 is presented to Ivana Manavis. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 1 is also presented to Isabella Mattis. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 1 is presented to Shauna Peppard. The medal for first place in Studies in Catholic Thought is presented to Stasia Tan. Second place in Studies in Catholic Thought is presented to Samantha Stevens.
third place in studies in Catholic thought is presented to Amani Adisho. Please join me in congratulating our Religious Education Award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Wood. I would now like to invite the Head of English, Ms. Natalia Hennessy, to join Mrs. Quirk on stage for the presentation of the English Awards. The medal for first place in English Extension 2 is presented to Rose Cattle. The medal for first place in English Extension 1 is presented to Elsa Lane. Elsa also receives the medal for first place in English Advanced. Second place in English Advanced is presented to Yasmin Jansek. Third place in English Advanced is presented to Amelia O'Leary. The medal for first place in English Standard is presented to Eliza Cook. Equal second place in English Standard is presented to Serena Assi. Equal second place in English Standard is also presented to Shauna Peppard. The medal for first place in English Studies is presented to Emma Rogers. Second place in English Studies is presented to Demi Kroketos. Please join me in congratulating our English Award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Hennessy. I would like to invite Mr. David Martin, Head of Human Society and its Environment, to present the HISI Awards. The medal for first place in Ancient History is presented to Olivia DeRujo. Second place in Ancient History is presented to Elsa Lane. Elsa also receives an award for second place in Economics. Second place in Business Studies is presented to Amelia O'Leary. the medal for first place in business studies is presented to Emma Carps. Third place in business studies is presented to Shauna Peppard. The medal for first place in economics is presented to Brina Connan. Brina also receives the medal for first place in legal studies. The medal for first place in geography is presented to Lily Robinson. Second place in geography is presented to Charlize Ashby. Third place in geography is presented to Ella Howard. Second place in legal studies is presented to Jacqueline Costagianis. Third place in legal studies is presented to Scarlett Forster. The medal for first place in modern history is presented to Ruby Robb. Ruby also receives the medal for first place in history extension. Second place in modern history is presented to Isabella Woods. The medal for first place in work studies is presented to Emma Rogers. Second place in work studies is presented to Serena Sue. The medal for first place in work in the community is presented to Sophia Otten. Please join me in congratulating our HISI Award recipient. Thank you, Mr. Martin. I would like to invite our Head of Mathematics, Mrs. Maya Mabey, to join Mrs. Quirk for the presentation of the Mathematics Awards. The medal for first place in Mathematics Extension 1 and Mathematics Extension 2 is presented to Emma Carps. The medal for first place in Mathematics Advanced is presented to Yasmin Jancic. Yasmin is also presented with second place in Mathematics Extension 1. Third place in Mathematics Extension 1 is presented to Annalisa Trupke. Second place in Mathematics Advanced is presented to Emily Levisianis. Equal third place in Mathematics Advanced is presented to Olivia DeRujo. Equal third place in Mathematics Advanced is also presented to Chloe Deng. Equal third place in Mathematics Advanced is also presented to Elsa Lane. The medal for first place in Mathematics Standard 2 is presented to Lily Townsend. Second place in Mathematics Standard 2 is presented to Charlotte Blackett. Equal third place in Mathematics Standard 2 is presented to Sarah Graff. Equal third place in Mathematics Standard 2 is also presented to Jessica Haler. Equal third place in Mathematics Standard 2 is also presented to Sophia Keith. Equal third place in Mathematics Standard 2 is presented to Taryn Lafferty. Equal third place in Mathematics Standard 2 is also presented to Shauna Peppard. Equal third place in Mathematics Standard 2 is presented to Lily Robinson. The medal for first place in Mathematics Standard 1 is presented to Emma Rogers. Second place in Mathematics Standard 1 is presented to Serena Sue. Please join me in congratulating our Mathematic Award recipients. Thank you, Miss Maybe. I would like to invite our Head of Music, Miss Jacqueline Hanafy, to present the Music Awards with Mrs. Quirk. The medal for first place in Music 1 is presented to Faith Mariana Borra. The medal for first place in Music 2 is presented to Yasmin Jancic. The medal for first place in Music Extension is presented to Ashley Wu. Please join me in congratulating our Music Award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Hanafy. I would now like to invite the Head of Personal Development, Health and Physical Education, Mrs. Vanessa Colhane, to present the PDHPE Awards with Mrs. Quirk. The medal for equal first place in Community and Family Studies is presented to Claire Culligan. Claire also receives the award for equal third place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Third place in Community and Family Studies is presented to Charlize Ashby. The medal for first place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education is presented to Caitlin D'Andrade. Caitlin also receives the medal for equal first place in Community and Family Studies. Second place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education is presented to Lily Robinson. Equal third place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education is presented to Shauna Peppard. Please join me in congratulating our PDHP Award recipients and thank you, Mrs. Colhane. I would now like to invite our Director of Curriculum, Ms. Eleonora Agazzi, to present the Science Awards. The medal for first place in biology is presented to Isabella Mattis. Equal second place in biology is presented to Serena Assi. Equal second place in biology is also presented to Emily Levisianis. The medal for first place in chemistry is presented to Olivia Koo. Second place in chemistry is presented to Ivana Manavis. The medal for first place in physics is presented to Emma Karps. Please join me in congratulating our Science Award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Agarzi. I would now like to invite our head of TAS and VET, Mrs. Kylie Little, to present the Technology and Applied Studies and Vocational Education Awards. The medal for first place in design and technology is presented to Amelia O'Leary. Second place in design and technology is presented to Annabel Mansour. Third place in design and technology is presented to Hayley Pizzanato. The medal for equal first place in food technology is presented to Lily Townsend. The medal for equal first place in food technology is also presented to Ashley Walker. Third place in food technology is presented to Sarah Graff. The medal for first place in industrial technology multimedia is presented to Brina Conan. The medal for first place in hospitality is presented to Samara Lecha. Second place in hospitality is presented to Lily Townsend. Third place in hospitality is presented to Sophie Murphy. Please join me in congratulating our TAS and VET award recipients. Thank you, Mrs. Little. I would like to invite our head of visual arts, Miss Melissa Nutter, to present the Visual Arts Awards. The medal for first place in visual arts is presented to Pearl Collins. Second place in visual arts is presented to Chloe Ashton. Please join me in congratulating our art award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Nutter. That concludes our academic awards, I would now like to hand over to Mrs. Norman to commence our special awards.
Thank you, Ms. Fox. It is now time in our ceremony where we present the special awards. Our first award this afternoon is the Catholic Education Foundation Social Justice and Excellence in Learning Award. To present this award, I would like to invite to the stage Sarah Nguyen from Sydney Catholic Schools to join Mrs. Sharon Quirk. This award is granted to a student who leads by example, displays empathy and compassion, is actively involved in social justice activities while having a consistent approach to her studies, and displays personal learning excellence. It is my pleasure to announce the recipient of this award, Matilda Dibb. Thank you, Sarah. Our next award is the Australian Defence Force Future Innovators Award. The Australian Defence Force is encouraging the next generation of innovators, critical thinkers, and problem solvers, bright Australian students who are succeeding in STEM. This award is presented to a student in Year 12 who has the ability to demonstrate innovation and learning in the fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. This year's recipient of the Australian Defence Force Innovator Award is Olivia Koo. The Australian Defence Force Long Tan Youth Leadership and Teamwork Award began in 2006 to recognise students who demonstrated these qualities within the school and the broader community. At the same time, the award recognises those students who display strong values such as doing one's best, respect for others, and mateship. The recipient of the 2023 Australian Defence Force Long Tan Youth Leadership and Teamwork Award is a student who has consistently demonstrated these skills in our college community and is always enthusiastic, engaging with learning. She approaches her studies in a positive manner, participates wholeheartedly in class activities, and works effectively both independently and as a team member. This student is to be commended for her resourcefulness and problem-solving skills and the manner in which she has demonstrated the way to evaluate, rethink, and refine approaches to tasks to take account of unexpected or difficult situations. This student is highly respected by her peers and staff. Her cheerful, cooperative, responsible, and capable nature is an asset. The Year 12 recipient of the Australian Defence Force Long Tan Youth Leadership and Teamwork Award is Emily Levisianis. Our next award is the Archbishop of Sydney Award for Student Excellence. This award is an annual recognition of the outstanding young women and men of faith in our Catholic schools. The award highlights the positive contribution that young people make to our school and communities. The award specifically recognises those students in Year 12 who give witness to their Catholic values and contribute actively to the faith life. These young people show responsible participation in the life, mission, and work of the Catholic faith community. I would like to invite to the stage Michelle Mansour to announce this award.
The recipient is a young student who is the epitome of spiritual leadership within the community of Bridgeton College and her parish. Her humble, understated approach to Catholic leadership encourages others around her to nurture and strengthen her own faith. Her deep spirituality and participation in liturgical activities such as Sunday school, youth group, church leadership courses, and art outreach program within her parish model a life of service. She brings her faith to life through her active participation in all aspects of the parish and college community through her weekly participation in Mass as College Faith and Charism Captain, established the inaugural morning Mass, now celebrated fortnightly at the college. She draws on her deep faith in her daily life, and her presence influences others in her community to follow her. The recipient for the Archbishop's Award for Student Excellence is Annabelle Mansour.
Thank you, girls. Our next award is the Principal's Art Award, and I would like to invite Miss Melissa Nutter to the stage to join Mrs. Quirk in presenting this award. The Principal's Year 12 Art Award was established in 2019 to recognise the incredible talent of our visual arts students. Each year, one student's artwork will be procured by the college with the desire to build over many years to come our very own Bridgeton Art Gallery. This year, we have joint recipients of this award. The first recipient of the Principal's Art Award goes to Nadia Dazon. Nadia's artwork is titled Assimilation. My body of work examines the feelings of cultural disconnection specifically experienced by immigrants and children of immigrants as one's loss of identity and belonging. Growing up as a first generation Asian Australian, I felt like a fake, masquerading on occasion specific identity. Through the family gatherings and the confusion that came with trying to understand both the Indonesian and Filipino language,
I couldn't help but feel distressed and uneasy as I gradually realised my heritage, traditions and background are slowly fading away. The second recipient of the Principal's Art Award is Sarah Lucas. Sarah's artwork is titled Set in Stone. My work, Set in Stone, is an exploration of captivating organic forms inspired by the fluidity and inherent beauty found in nature's intricate patterns. Through rich colours and elaborate patterns, each tile becomes a canvas which captures the essence of organic forms as testament to the profound relationship between art and nature. The raw clay allows me to shape and mould into organic shapes that mirror the gentle curves of leaves, the sinuous flow of rivers, or the intricate patterns of tree nuts found on the floor of earth. Through my ceramic tiles, I hope to evoke a sense of kinship between nature and humanity, reminding the audience of their inexplicable connection to the natural world. Congratulations, Nadia and Sarah. Thank you, Melissa. Our next award is the Sister Helen Connolly Memorial Music Award. This award is given in memory of Sister Helen Connolly, who was principal at Brigidine from 1981 to 1988 and provincial leader of the Brigidine Sisters. This award recognises a student who has shown a strong commitment to the musical life of the college. The recipient of this award has demonstrated her commitment to music through her involvement in both the junior and college orchestras as a violinist, her participation in the many small instrumental ensembles, including the Latines, Church Orchestra, and String Ensemble, and her dedication to the college choir and her leadership as the junior orchestra leader, choir leader, and leader of the a cappella group. This student is a great musical all-rounder. The recipient of the Sister Helen Connolly Memorial Music Award in 2023 is Sarah Birrell. Our next award is the Cedric Ashton Award for Musical Excellence. This award for musical excellence is given in memory of Cedric Ashton, who was a member of the Sydney Symphony Orchestra and a cello tutor at Brigidine College for over 40 years. The recipient of this award has demonstrated her commitment to music through her dedication as a skilled musician who has shared her talents as the resident mallet percussionist for junior orchestra and pianist for college orchestra. Her commitment to practice and performance and her expertise as a highly skilled pianist. In 2023, the Cedric Ashton Award for Musical Excellence is presented to Ashley Wu. The Senior Oratory Award is presented to the student who has shown consistent commitment to both debating and oratory at Brigidine. This student has been exemplary in her contribution and outstanding in her skills in public speaking. Her talents have been demonstrated on many occasions, and her eloquence is admired by all who have had the opportunity to hear her speak. This year's recipient is Brina Connan. The Jan Foley Award is named in honour of Mrs. Jan Foley, who was the principal at Brigidine College from 2000 to 2007. Jan was very supportive of the whole Brigidine community and was a firm believer in supporting all students, particularly those who persevered in the face of adversity. The Jan Foley Award is presented to a girl who has demonstrated perseverance, positivity, and an ever-engaging smile in spite of a number of challenges during her time at Brigidine. The 2023 recipient of the Jan Foley Award is Sophia Otten. The Diana Hitchens Award for Community Service is named in honour of Diana Hitchens, who was a much-loved member of the college community. She was an ex-student who worked in the library and as a special education teacher, and in her interactions with students and staff, she exemplified the qualities of strength and gentleness. The all-round manner in which the 2023 recipient conducts herself is her key defining feature. Her peers, the teaching staff, and the broader college community respect her for her presence and her achievements that she brings to the college. She involves herself selflessly and without any expectation of reward or profile. She has time for students in the college, and without presumption or undue fuss, adopts the responsibilities associated with being a role model. The 2023 recipient not only has outstanding potential, but she continually reinforces the same through her broad-ranging dedication to both her academic and community endeavours. This year, the award goes to Amani Odisho. The Kildare Awards recognise those girls who have contributed to our community with generosity and initiative. Always aware of keeping the spirit of St. Bridget alive in the college. St. Bridget established her abbey in Kildare, and it became famous throughout Europe for its hospitality, culture, worship, and education. The Kildare Award recipients are Sarah Birrell, Claire Culligan, Caitlin D'Andrade, Olivia DeRujo, Holly Gray, Roisin Hayenga, Caitlin Indrawan. Jacqueline Costagianis. Sarah Lucas, Sarah Lucas. Charlie Limbry Ashton. Bridie Morrison. Amelia O'Leary. Ruby Robb. Ellie Shearman. And Isabella Woods. The Bishop Delaney Award is drawn from the Kildare Awards. The recipients of this award are an exemplary embodiment of the Kildare Awards. This year, the Bishop Delaney Award is presented to Sarah Birrell. Please join me in congratulating these award recipients. Our next award is the St. Bridget's Cup for contribution to the religious life of the college. St. Bridget's Cup for contribution to the religious life of the college is awarded to a student who has made a consistent and enthusiastic effort to promote gospel values. She demonstrates Christian leadership through the example that she sets and the positive relationships that she has with her peers and teachers. In encouraging faith in our Bridgetine community, she has always been a gentle witness, leading by example. The recipient of the St. Bridget's Cup is a student who is gentle and kind and leads others joyfully. It is with much pleasure that I announce the recipient for the 2023 St. Bridget's Cup for contribution to the religious life of the college, Annabel Mansour. Our next award is the Founders' Cup for Initiative and Service and acknowledges a student who has shown both qualities of initiative and service during her senior years at the college. This student is a prominent student in both college and community projects. The recipient is genuine and sincere in her actions and has always maintained a high academic standing throughout all her contributions. She consistently has the welfare of others at heart and will leave a legacy of kindness at Bridgetine. The Founders' Cup for Initiative and Service is awarded to Eliza Cook. Our next award is the Principal's Award for Leadership and Contribution to College Life. This is awarded to the student who is generous with her time and has done much to promote the welfare of the college through her successful involvement in and leadership of college activities. The recipient has provided outstanding leadership and contribution to Bridgetine College on a continual and exemplary basis. She has embraced every aspect of college life. She is charismatic, generous with her time, and ever conscious of those around her. The recipient of the Leadership and Outstanding Contribution to College Life Award is Yasmin Yanchek. The College Cup for Outstanding Efforts in Studies recognises the exceptional way in which a student has approached her studies. The recipient of this award has been consistent in her academic efforts and application throughout years 11 and 12. This student engages enthusiastically in her classwork and is highly motivated to meet new challenges and achieve her best at all times. The College Cup for Outstanding Effort in Studies is awarded to Emma Carps. The final award, and Bridget Ean College's most prestigious major award, is the Fortiter et Suaviter Award for all-round excellence. This award recognises a student at the college who exemplifies the qualities espoused in our motto, Fortiter et Suaviter, to act with strength and gentleness. Our motto reflects the virtues of strength and gentleness, so characteristic of St. Bridget, and was also adopted by the congregation of the Sisters of St. Bridget. The recipient of this award is a truly inspirational student who is genuine and sincere in her commitment to the college. To shine the light for others definitely comes naturally for this student. She has approached everything she does with an unmatched enthusiasm and dedication. Her devotion to the community of Bridget Ean College is exemplified by her membership of a wide array of college activities. Her enthusiasm for college life sets a standard for others to aspire to. The Fortiter et Suaviter recipient is an outstanding student and person, someone who both inspires and leads through practical example, and who I am sure truly embodies the spirit and values of our college and St. Bridget. She has been a truly inspirational student, and she leaves this college with a legacy that will remain forever enshrined in our college spirit. It gives me great pleasure to announce that the recipient of the 2023 Fortiter et Suaviter Award is Emily Levisianis. Congratulations once again, girls. This now concludes our academic and special awards for 2023. On behalf of our college principal and our college staff, I offer my warmest congratulations to all Year 12 students today. Let's give them all another round of applause. I would now like to welcome to the stage our college captain, Yasmin Janshek.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Quirk, executive, staff, invited guests, families, and especially to the graduating class of 2023. I started to write this speech the night we came back from retreat. I guess that's when it really started to hit me that we were actually graduating in 2 weeks from then, which Miss Wood reiterated many times, as she just can't bear to say goodbye to her favourite year. And as we boarded the bus to go home, someone called out, "Say goodbye, this is the last time we'll see this place." For some reason, that came as a shock to me, and I realised that, yes, we'll likely never see Benedict Retreat Centre again. This period is full of last times and goodbyes. Little by little, without even knowing it, we've been saying goodbyes to the parts of us that we're going to leave behind here. The retreat bus began to depart, and that chapter of our lives was over. at least until I realized I'd left my jumper by the trampoline and had to stop the bus and sprint back up the hill to retrieve it. And once I'd grabbed it, huffing and puffing, I had a little moment where I slowed down and just smiled because it hit me that nothing is really final, not even goodbyes. There's almost always a path back to the places we love, even if it's a hill, and the people we hold close, even if it's through memory. I think that as a U group, we've all been quite focused on the end point of this journey that we embarked on 6 years ago. It's been graduation, then formal, then HSC. But I know we've all heard the saying that the journey is more important than the destination. It's the challenges and successes we face that shape us into who we are. With that in mind, let's go back to 2018 and relive our journey together from year seven. A group of strangers walked through the front gates on Aeolia Street. We were giddy with nerves and excitement, both fearful and hopeful at the possibilities of the future. We were introduced to our homerooms and played human bingo. From that day, I remember that Eleni had multiple pets and Charlie was a Rooster supporter. And it's so crazy to think at this point that's about all we knew of each other. We went from these wide-eyed kids fumbling our way through the maze that was high school to these mature young adults ready to go out into the world and do incredible things. Throughout the next few years, we made so many new friends, changing friendship groups multiple times, thoroughly embraced the dramatic increase in popularity of TikTok, bought daily frozen cups from the canteen, attended homeroom Zooms while in bed throughout remote learning, Liz, and did near professional dance performances in PE, shout out to my Vogue girls in 2020. And then we happened upon our senior years. We started to understand what hard work really looks like, and we held each other up through the immense struggle of writing an essay to an unseen question. We were introduced to the teachers that would become our mentors, who have challenged us to think beyond the limits of what we thought our brains were capable of, though I still can't seem to get the hang of financial maths. We've listened to Mr. Gartzi banging on the table to very effectively and engagingly make a point. We've eaten to our heart's content on retreat, and more importantly, watched Miss Wood lose in Uno. We've sung Eagle's Wings and Hymn to St. Bridget one too many times. We've sunbaked in the pockets of sunlight in Declan and huddled together in them when it's cold. We've crammed together on this very stage to sing Don't Stop Believing together. We've seen people come and go, but ensure that everyone feels like a part of this family. And that leads us to today. Today is September 20th, and today marks our last day of high school. To be honest, it's been a little hard for me to comprehend that this is all coming to an end. And while it will be a blessing to sleep in whenever we want, it's going to be hard to adjust to a life without the steady routine of school, to a life without daily recess and lunch with our friends, to a life without seeing our teachers every day. But while we will have to be a bit more independent, take comfort in the fact that we'll still be able to depend on each other, because we've formed bonds and memories that are lasting. And if you're in Regina, you'll be familiar with Sarah Lucas's daily questions. And the question for this week was, would you rather have a photographic memory capturing all childhood memories, or make certain one aspect of your future? I've heard some mixed answers, but I'm leaning towards the photographic memory because our memories are what have shaped our journey and who we are. They hold such a special place in our hearts. The future is uncertain, but isn't that a good thing? Isn't it exciting that the possibilities are endless? And now I have a lot of thank yous to give. I want to give the biggest thank you to our families, who we have depended on and leaned on throughout our years at the school. Honestly, I don't know how we would have even begun to achieve our goals without the endless support from our families. They've been our source of strength, and for that I give the most heartfelt thanks. You've been there for us since the beginning of kindergarten, way back when. You've packed thousands of lunches and navigated the complex world of Compass. You've ridden the numerous ups and downs with us, and no words could really describe the extent of our gratitude to you. To our teachers, you have poured your heart and soul into preparing us for either the HSC or whatever the next stage in our lives will be. Shaping young minds is by no means an easy task, but you have instilled within us all the tools we need to be confident when approaching the coming months. You've made learning fun and exciting as well as challenging, and you've laughed with us through those challenges. We will forever be grateful to you. To Mrs. Quirk and the college executive, thank you for allowing the leadership team to live out our vision to contribute positively to the community around us. The dedication that you showed to this school is unparalleled, and the support you offered the students does not go unnoticed. We are so grateful for your support and constant engagement with the students. A special thank you and farewell to the teachers who will be leaving us next term, and the best of luck for whatever your future holds. To Mrs. Parsons, I don't even know where to start. You've honestly been our rock, ever supportive and nurturing. You've been so selfless and generous, taking on our burdens and stressing just as much as us, probably more, about our exams. It means a lot that you care so much about every one of us. We wouldn't have wanted anyone else to oversee our high school journey and make sure that we were always acting with compassion towards each other. Miss, stop crying, I'm gonna cry. The maturity and capability that I see when looking out at this year group is a testament to your leadership and guiding presence. Thank you also from the bottom of my heart for supporting the leadership team in all of our initiatives and for being such an integral part of our successes. To the leadership team, we set out with the goal of leaving a legacy of fun, friendship, and inclusivity, and we've achieved that. We've partied in the main quad at feast day, gotten students and teachers alike doing push-ups all over the school, sung to some unsuspecting people for Valentine's Day, shared chocolate hearts as a random act of kindness, and appealed to a collective love of pink lemonade, pizza, and bake sales. Through all this, we've managed to raise money and awareness for countless social justice initiatives and fulfill our goal of service. So a massive, massive thank you to the profile and house captains for implementing our vision with smiles on your faces and for leading this college with an example of strength and gentleness. To Emily, you are quite honestly the best person that I know. Where are you, Emily? Where is she? There. Your unfailing generosity and selflessness never ceases to amaze me. You carry yourself with a smile on your face. That's impossible not to smile back at. I wouldn't have wanted to work alongside anyone else in this final year of school. And I can't express how grateful I am for your constant support and the eagerness you approach every task with. Thanks, Miss. If anyone was ever the embodiment of strength and gentleness, it's you. It's been an absolute honor to achieve our goals together. To Sienna and Liv and the leadership team of 2024, I couldn't think of a better group of people to lead this college, and I'm so excited to see everything that you achieve next year. And finally, to the graduating class of 2023, we did it! Yay! It has been an absolute privilege to be part of such an amazing group of people. Together, we have conquered school and will most definitely go on to conquer the HSC. As we've heard Miss Fox say many times before, the HSC is a marathon, not a sprint, and we're on the home stretch now. So, while this is the end of the road, it's actually just the end of one road. Just as it has millions of times before, this complex and convoluted path that is our lives will fork again, and we will make choices and explore opportunities, make mistakes, be challenged, and ultimately find a path that fulfills us. Because challenges are what give us room to grow, to understand ourselves, to feel content and proud. So, as we sang together once before, please don't stop believing, hold on to that feeling. In other words, take a bit of time to reflect on the significance of our high school journey and learning and friendships, and then get excited about what the future holds. I can't wait to see where this journey of life ends up taking you all. Thank you.
Thank you. So Year 12s, if you just sit for a little moment, there's one crucial part of our ceremony that we're yet to perform. But first, I think it's important that we actually explain this part, and that is the movement of the tassel. There are many symbols that signify your graduation, but none other than the graduation tassel. It is the symbol of success. When you entered for your graduation today, you place the tassel on the right-hand side of your cap to signify that you have the right to graduate. As you have successfully completed your secondary education and walked the stage, a symbolic gesture of crossing over from high school to your next stage in life is to move the tassel on your cap to the left. So may I ask the college graduating class of 2023 to please stand. Please take your tassel and move it from the right-hand side to the left. Yes, Ava, you have officially graduated. And now for your college captain's last expressions on your graduation, I'm going to leave this final movement to her.
Okay, year 12, this is the moment we've all been waiting for. But just before we get to that, Jessica Winter just reminded me, because I forgot to say, girls can do anything, but Bridgetine girls can do everything. So,
you may like to get your cameras out.
Yeah, I would. Okay, year 12, can I ask you please to take your cap off and hold it in your hand? We're going to be throwing them up. Cameras all out. Okay. On the count of three, we're going to throw them in the air, okay? Ready? One, two, three! Yeah!
Thank you very much, Yasmin. Okay, ladies, just one more minute. Just one more minute. So before our proceedings come to an end, it is most appropriate to publicly acknowledge and thank all those people who have contributed to making today such a success and so special for Year 12. I am sure that the Year 12 students would also like to thank their parents and siblings for all the support they have received and for the continued support they will receive over the coming weeks. I would now like to ask everybody to stand and to applaud the graduating class of 2023.